Hello and welcome back to this live coverage of Kotmale Under 19 Football Tournament 2016. As we are about to commence the fourth and final quarter final between Holy Cross College and Kingswood College Kandy. We just witnessed the match between St. Henry College Illawarra versus Dharmaraja College Kandy. Just finished a few moments ago. St. Henry College taking the win 4-1. Rajan's getting thrashed by the boys from Jaffna. And here we are to see live action of this fourth and final quarter final between Kingswood College and Holy Cross College as the teams line up to be introduced and the play will start in a few moments. Till then, I will just go through the team lineup of Kingswood College. V.I. Ekanayaka, H.M. Shamil, B.B. Nishantha, G.M. Alas, A.C. Vikramasinghe, M.C. Dilruan, R.B. Madurava, M. Nazir, Abdul Khadir, and S.D. Vijay Rayana. That is the playing 11 for Kingswood College, while Holy Cross College, the players will be Dulanja Pereira, Rohit Bolongno, Subhash Pingo, Govinda Sudeep, Ashen Primantha, Kavinda Kumara, Marshall Fernando, Udara Pereira, Mohamed Sami, Shanuka Fernando, and Salindu Kure. Only one spot left in the semi-final of this Kotmale Under 19 football tournament. As the players pose for a final photo. Play will commence in a short while. Stay tuned to www.thepapare.com. We'll bring you live action of this fourth and final quarterfinal and as well the semi-final on the 17th of February, that is Tuesday, or 16th of February, that is Tuesday. It should be held at West Coast Grounds as well as the finals, and the third place playoff will be held on Friday the 19th at Race Course Grounds. That will also be live broadcasted on www.thepapare.com. So please stay tuned for updates on this Kotmale Under 19 Football League. Teams huddling up to discuss the final few things just to get their head straight and get their concentration on this all-important knockout match. Only one spot remaining in the semi-finals. Today, St. Henry Illawarra qualified after beating Dharmaraja College in the previous quarter-final. It will be Kingswood College with a kick-start the fourth quarter-final. And that is the opening whistle of this match. Kingswood with the ball, first up. Kingswood wearing their usual maroon and blue jersey, while Holy Cross is dressed in maroon and orange. It's sparked in colors. Cross on the attack for the first time. The shot deflected from the Holy Cross player. It will be a goal kick for Kingswood College. It's number 16 for Holy Cross College, making a good run on the left-hand side of the pitch. But well defended by the Holy Cross player. The throw in for Holy Cross College. Very high ball there. Ball rolls away for another throw in for Holy Cross. Joined with Faslan here at the com box.
Yes, Ranjika, thank you very much. You missed a couple of good matches yesterday as Zaira won against Maristella, and on the other side, St. Sebastian's Katudenia, if I'm not mistaken, qualified for the semi-finals. And today we have Kingswood and Holy Cross Kalthara.
Yes, St. Sebastian and Zaira qualified yesterday to the semi-finals, and today we had St. Henry Illawarra who qualified in the previous match, beating Dharmaraja College, and this is the fourth and final quarter-final between Holy Cross Kalthara and Kingswood College. Candy School is in the quarterfinals. Unfortunately, Dharmaraja had to go out of the tournament. Sure, Kingswood will give up a good fight against Holy Cross College.
Not to forget, Ranjika, both the Candy Schools have a huge place in rugby, the rugby arena. And over here, we have Holy Cross fighting a place in the semifinals.
a bit of a tussle there inside Holy Cross half. It would be a throw-in for Kingswood College. It's a good opportunity. They are to make some inroads in this match.
There goes Menuka, the goalkeeper for Holy Cross.
Good through ball from Holy Cross, but goalkeeper running in and gathering the ball cleanly.
As I've been informed, there's a club player for Kingswood College. His name is Mohammed Shamin, who's wearing the jersey number 8. And also we have Anjana Vikramasinghe, the young lad who plays for the Sri Lankan U19 schools team. He's a striker. But today he's playing as a defender.
We have a player down on the ground. It's the Holy Cross player. He's getting some attention there, and it will be the first free kick of the match for Holy Cross from the left hand side of the pitch. It will be a chance for Holy Cross to draw first blood in this fourth and final quarter final.
What do you think, Ranjika? The Kingswood coach has chosen the Sri Lankan striker to play as the defender.
Yes, surprising tactic there by the coach. I'm not quite sure the reason behind it. Maybe he's nursing an injury. Maybe he's trying to save him.
What I think here is he's an all-rounder, so he can play anywhere. That's a major advantage for a school player.
Yes, even in the previous match, we saw Desha Priya, who represented his team in the sevens, recently concluded sevens. Schools under 19 played a brilliant role in the rugby team as well. In this match, he was the only player to score a goal for Dharmaraj College. So yeah, all-round players, all-round as Kingswood number 16 goes past two defenders, but well recovered by number 12. That's Holy Cross number 12 jersey, Ashen Primanta, who ran behind and kicked the ball away.
If either of the teams get to score in the early half, that'll be a huge advantage for them, as like yesterday, it's a reality they get a chance to score in the second half. Yesterday they had a better comeback against Zaira. Marcella had a comeback, but it was not very successful. It was 2-1. And today the previous match was 4-1. St. Henry's College Jaffna has dominated the game against Dharmaraj College Kandy.
Yes, indeed, total domination shown by the boys from Jeff now, who is still at the grounds, who is having a small discussion down there in the shade. Must be really thrilled to have reached the semi-final stage, this Kotmale Under-19 All-Ireland football tournament.
Has dominated the game.
Holy Cross on the attack. Both teams are still settling down to the game. Still early stages, first quarter of the match.
There's Nazir for Kingswood College clearing the defense.
Beautiful scenes here at the racecourse grounds. There's a small breeze blowing across the field. It must be soothing for the players. It's really hot out there. There's no shade whatsoever inside in the playing field. So I'm sure the breeze must be comforting for these young lads.
That's Anjana clearing the defense again for Kingswood College. That was a good opportunity for Holy Cross. They could have made use of it instead of taking a shot in front of the post.
Anjana showing his defensive skills. Like I said, a talented player and all-rounder. He's a striker for the national side, but a defender for his school. Foul against that Kingswood player to be a free kick for Kingswood inside their own half. Can see some few Holy Cross supporters in the grandstand with their flags out. It is also the Big Mac season coming up for you. March Madness. We will be showing you live coverage of a few of the very well-known popular Big Matches as Holy Cross with a good ball in. He goes past the defender. And Holy Cross still with the ball, but not enough support there, unfortunately, for Holy Cross. It's an opportunity gone begging. So I was saying, it's very busy schedule for all of us at ThePapare.com. We've been showing you live coverage of cricket matches, football matches, rugby matches throughout these first few months of 2016. And there will be more matches coming up. Please stay tuned to www.thepapare.com.
Of course, Ranjika, we have the big matches coming up for cricket and then the ongoing Dialogue Rugby League. And then schools football, and then we have schools rugby as well starting in few months.
Holy Cross have maintained a position in the final few minutes, last few minutes rather, at this occasion. Kingswood pushing forward. They have space and a few players inside the box, but well defended and cleared away by that Holy Cross defense. That's a foul against Kingswood College, and that will be a free kick and a chance for the boys from Kandy to break through in this fourth and final quarter final.
That's a free kick over to Kingswood College, Kandy, and that's Anjana Wickremasinghe taking the free kick. Referee says out ball. That was a good kick though by Anjana. Anjana getting back to his position in the defense line.
Kingswood College with the ball now. Cheaply gave away a position in that occasion. That will be a throw-in for Holy Cross.
In the defense line, Nishantha pairing up with Anjana as center defenders, and along with them we have M. Nazi on the right back and D. Madhurava in left back.
That was Kavindu Kumara, who was controlling the ball well in the midfield. But Kingswood again good in their defense. And that's a foul conceded by Shanuka Fernando. Late tackle.
That's Anjan Wickremasinghe again for Kingswood College taking the free kick.
Anjana showing his skills with the boot. The good firepower in that shot by Anjana. Sri Lanka under 19 player. He seems to be controlling the game from the back. Fazlan making the calls for Kingswood College.
Of course, Ranjika, a very, very experienced player he is, so he has to control the game. Playing as a striker for the Sri Lankan team and playing as a center back for school, is it makes a huge difference on the pitch. So he has enough and more experience to control the game. So yes, he does. On the other hand, not to forget, Holy Cross has produced many national players, and Sujan Pereira is one of them, who is a goalkeeper, and he's the captain of the Sri Lanka team. So Holy Cross should make him proud today, I guess.
Stolen by number 11, that is Sudara Pereira, who stole the ball, couldn't find any support in the middle. Still both teams settling down. We haven't seen much consistency by both teams. They've been sloppy so far, and there will be a change in the commentary box. It will be Lelum M and Navod Vijay Vikrama. I'm sorry, Navod will be coming in later. Good afternoon, Lelum.
Good afternoon, Ranjika. The fourth and the final quarterfinal of the Kotpale Chocks on the 19 Football Championship 2015. Another school from Kandy qualifying into this stage and playing against Holy Cross Kalutra. over the top into the attacking side of the Kingswood boys as they chase it down, but they couldn't quite get hold of it as it goes over the side. Then could be a quick throw-in for the boys from Kalutra.
Kingswood with the throw-in. And that will be another throw-in for Kingswood.
Quick throw-in taken into the deep. Missing the first opportunity there, the goalkeeper giving a second chance to the boys from Kandy, but even they couldn't really capitalize on it and get the right target or the right aim into the goal as they missed that. It'll be a goal kick for the boys from Kalutra. Doesn't quite kick it deep, just falls near the halfway line. And it was a tough ask for them to build a position from there as Kingswood defenders clear it off onto the sidelines. Another throw-in for the Holy Cross boys. They've been having opportunities since the start. They just couldn't finish it in a fine manner. And now, right outside the box, a good opportunity here. Puts it way, and the goalkeeper is way off. And that's the first goal, the maiden goal in this fourth quarter final.
That's number 11, Udara Pereira for Holy Cross College, scoring the first goal. Again, another mistake, misjudgment by the goalkeeper of Kingswood College. This whole both matches have been, we have seen so many mistakes by the goalkeepers, even in the previous match, even in yesterday's matches. But nevertheless, credit should go to Udara Pereira, finding the target in that occasion. Holy Cross leading 1-0.
Indeed, Udara Pereira, beautiful job by him. It was laid off beautifully in front of him. It was just a matter of finding the right pace and giving the energetic boost to the ball. And he did it in the best possible manner. And once the goalkeeper was way off his mark, it was just a simple task for him to chip it on the side. And the ball will find its way to the goal. And that's the first booking of the match as the Kingswood player goes into the books of the referee. The first yellow card. And it will be a free kick in favour of Holy Cross Kalutra. Another much needed opportunity to score an extra goal in this half and be on top of the cards. And as Ranjika very rightly mentioned, the goalkeepers have been very itchy during this three games which was concluded in the time period before. A good free kick with power, but too much elevation on it as it just goes away on the side. They wouldn't be too much damned as they already have scored that all-important first goal. They are on the lead, so it's pressure back on the Kandy boys.
Yes, Holy Cross College in the lead as Kingswood, number 16, goes past the defender, but well recovered by number 3, that is Dulanja Pereira, who comes across and clears the ball away for Holy Cross College.
Holy Cross once again in position, deemed by the defence of the Kingswood boys. Good ball played there, hitting it in the gaps, chasing the defenders. Turnover ball for Kingswood, now looking for options to get past the defence line. does it well this time, just outside the box. Good clear cut opportunity here, but just makes a miss of it. That was RB Madhurave. As the referee calls on for the medic to the field. The sun just sitting on the side, giving a huge bit of glare. And as we see, the stretcher comes out of the field. Not quite good concerns for the boys from Kalutara. Even though they are leading this game, there's another full entire half right after 15 minute break where the Candy boys could make a comeback. And the player will be treated on the sidelines as the referee will resume play. From that point onwards, it will be a free kick in favour of the Holy Cross boys, Kalutara.
Yes, free kick inside their own half. Holy Cross College leading 1-0. This final quarter final. Kingswood deep inside their own half. Fine bit of footwork there by the defender. It's Anjana again, the national under-19 cap.
Kingswood does have the talent and the potential to go all the way through to the semi-finals. They need to make sure they execute the plans properly. They have discussed prior to the game as Vikramasinghe gets the ball over the box, but just falls straight to the hands of the goalkeeper, makes no mistake in collecting it cleanly. They are having a confidence boost right now with that early goal scored in the first half, as the goal kick is sent back and brought forward by the Holy Cross players.
Holy Cross clearly must feel confident out there after that goal being scored in the first quarter of the match. It's always good to take the lead up front in these knockout stages. It's a lot of pressure in these young lads. As Kingswood seal the ball inside the Holy Cross half, and that will be a corner for Kingswood College. First corner, if I'm not mistaken, in this match, taken by Kingswood College. The foul there inside the box, and it will be a free kick for Holy Cross. Another foul conceded by Kingswood.
Free kick opportunity, but just falls straight in front of the Kingswood player there. Recovered well by the Kalutara lads though. In front of the box, deemed by the defence. Good piece of defencing there by the Kingswood boys. Pressing them right up front, not giving any space to break free and go for those through balls. Be quick in their legs. Adjusting positions quickly is what Kingswood just did right there, and hence it will be a throw in for Holy Cross as they cleared the ball away out on the sideline.
It's another free kick for Holy Cross. Just outside the box, it was fouled by the Kingswood defender. Is number 14 who is on the ground, Marcio Fernando for Holy Cross College winning that free kick. And this is another opportunity to go 2-0 up in this quarter-final, the final quarter-final.
A free kick in just the perfect position where the Holy Cross boys would have loved it. Just probably 20 meters out. And it'll be a good chance for them to convert into a scoring opportunity. Sends it over the top, and that is another goal scored by Holy Cross. What opportunity. It was a brilliant free kick placement there. Just 20 meters out on the edge of the box. And he just sent it all the way over the top of the blind wall. And it just ended up in the nets. And that's the second goal coming all the way from Kalutra.
Brilliant stuff by Holy Cross College. That is number 7, Kavindu Kumara, who has sent that ball all the way inside the goal from outside the penalty box, curving it in to score their second goal of the match. Holy Cross College leading 2-0.
And now the Kingswoods with the restart for the game. A lot of pressure on their shoulders. They might have to regroup and re-strategize during the halftime break and come back into this game with a better performance. That's what the St. Henry's boys from Jaffna just did in the previous game. Their second half performance was just brilliant, where they scored 3 goals and won the game 4-1. The third quarter final of this Kotmale Chalks and 19 Football Championship 2015. And as we speak, what another opportunity. Of course, gone begging for Holy Cross College Kalutra. They had everything in that beautiful position, brought the ball up front with good pace, but in the end just couldn't connect it through for a good shot to finish it off in the perfect manner. And hence it will be a corner kick in favor of the visitors.
The boys from Kalutra are doing well in this quarter final as the ball curves in towards the box. Another chance, but in that occasion the direction lacking in that header by the Holy Cross player, but a brilliant corner taken by Holy Cross. They are looking lethal in this first half.
Clear away by the Candy Boys. Ball in the middle, close tussle. And it's a beautiful factor to witness all these outstation schools playing such good football, coming into Colombo and playing against the top schools in the Candy District. Both St. Henry's College and Holy Cross College coming far away off city limits, doing well in their matches, and that time collected cleanly by the Kingswood goalkeeper, called for it and just laid his hands there for the ball to come inside the box. Opportunity here for Kingswood. That's Ekanayaka, who just crossed the ball through, but unfortunately it was cleared away by the defense line and recovered well. Now in the attacking half for Kingswood College, looking for options, trying to build possession, sends it over inside the box, falls right in front of the goalkeeper, makes no mistake in collecting it. It will be a goal kick for Holy Cross. Good kick into the half side. But the Kingswood defense was quick to arrive, as they have control. They had control, but right now it's Holy Cross outside the box. Can this be another goal? puts a cross in, beautifully laid over, just missed the head. He'll be disappointed. It was a beautiful through ball.
Brilliant stuff. That was the
Pragit Mansha Fernando. Ranjit, it was Pragit Mansha Fernando who just put that cross into the box, beautifully laid in by him. But unfortunately, his teammate just couldn't get perfect placement on the header. And that opportunity just went begging. And another good chance here inside the box, but kept down low by the goalkeeper. If you just see after that second goal, Ranjika, it's been all Holy Cross who's been doing the talking in this match.
So I think most of this half have been in favour of Holy Cross College. They've dominated the ball position in this first half. The scoreline clearly shows that how dominant they have been in this first half of the match. Kingswood will have to play their A game if they are to make a comeback in this match. Kingswood unable to keep the ball with them at the moment, just giving away position, just like Rajans did in the previous match. St. Henry was given the luxury of maintaining ball position almost all the time in the second half, and they pounced on that opportunity and scored three goals in the second half itself.
Kingswood College brings it into the attacking half, but doesn't quite get hold of it. They will have a throw in just outside the sideline, and the Czech flag goes up. It will be in favour of Kingswood College once again. So back-to-back throw-ins for them. Cleanly collected. Going for the goal kick is Holy Cross College Kaltura goalkeeper. Puts it up front. Ball high in the air. Falls not on the exact same place as he would have expected, as it just bounces off out of the sideline, giving a cheap ball position away for the Kingswood lads. But even though they had ball position, they couldn't really capitalize it. Crossing that white line. Illegal throw in. Referee says, with the Czech flag going up, and once again Holy Cross College Kalutra, they have the ball with them in the attacking half. Now sends it across just in front of the box, puts a beautiful through ball, another beautiful opportunity. Missed the first time, and even in the second time it was a miss hit as it was collected on the up by the goalkeeper of Kingswood College, Kandy.
The first Marcio Fernando who missed that opportunity for Holy Cross College. He slipped inside the penalty box. Unfortunate for the boys from Kalutara. Could have been 3-0 up in this match. We are still in the first half. It's a corner for Holy Cross. ball curving in, fended off by the goalkeeper. Kingswood on the counter attack now. They have players, they have support players in front. They are still maintaining position, but again, and that's a foul conceded by the whole cross play. It will be a free kick. Way off target by number 21, Kingswood College, throwing that opportunity away. Could have troubled the scorecard from that free kick, but it did not work out for the Kingswood players.
Beautiful chip over there, but falls just in the hands of in the safe hands of the Kingswood College goalkeeper as he takes the goal kick deep into the attacking half. Good opportunity there, but the lad from Kalaturu comes all the way, rises up high and punches it up front. Position gone begging for the Kingswood boys. The final few minutes of the first half operating at the West Coast International Stadium, bringing you the live action of the final, quarter-final of this Under-19 Schools Football Championship, lavishly sponsored by Kotmale Chalks. Kingswood College in the attack, outside the box, but the defense of the Holy Cross boys was quite well good there. Even though they cleared it off for a corner, they did not give any chance for him to cross through to the box, where the opportunity would have been more easy than they anticipated, to be precise. So they should be happy as they just cleared it off for a corner.
Crosses in towards the box, but cleared away by Holy Cross. We are closing in on the half time. Think it will be 1 minute of added time in the first half.
So it's the final minute which is operating here in the first half, as the Holy Cross College Kalaturu leads this game 2-0, courtesy of two beautiful goals scored in the first few minutes. And we have two players down on both the teams, as the referee and the teammates attend to them.
Anjana will take the free kick for Kingswood. It will be a good end to this first half if they are to score from here. But again, a wavered free kick from Anjana. Be a goal kick for Holy Cross College. And that's a poor piece of defense by Kingswood College as it's another opportunity gone begging. It's a goal scorer Udara Pereira who missed that heading, not getting his direction right. Unfortunate for Holy Cross College.
Indeed, Ranjika, it was brought forward beautifully, but that header once again missing the target. And there goes the sign, one extra minute added just before half time, so it's 60 seconds more for either sides to create a goal scoring opportunity.
We crossed still with a chance. It will be a line out for Holy Cross College. Holy Cross are taking their time. They are already ahead in the game.
And that's half-time here in the final, rather the fourth quarter-final of this Kotmale Chocks and 19 Schools Football Championship. As Holy Cross College, Kalutra leads this game 2-0. And of course, Kingswood, they might have to re-strategize and come up with new plans into the second half to play good football, to be threatening for these lads from Kalutra. And stay tuned on ThePapare.com as we will bring the action live to your doorstep.
Now transact with over 40 million EasyCash customers via Dialog, Etisalat and Hutch. Dial #111# to register today. Now use selected commercial bank ATMs to withdraw EasyCash at your convenience. Now I can withdraw EasyCash from any commercial bank ATM which displays the EasyCash logo. Select cardless transactions. Select your preferred language. Select EasyCash. Type in the amount you need. Enter your EasyCash account number. You will receive a message onto your mobile. Enter your EasyCash PIN and send to complete your transaction. Now use commercial bank ATMs to withdraw EasyCash at your convenience. Call 7111 for more information. EasyCash, money in your mobile. Connect to Sri Lanka's largest Wi-Fi network with over 2,500 hotspots across the country. Cafes, restaurants, colleges, hospitals, bus stands, train stations, and many more. Select Dialog Wi-Fi and visit wifi.dialog.lk to register and get your username and password. Choose from four easy ways to top up your account. Go Wi-Fi, go Dialog.
Sri Lanka is a small but proud nation, and we know we can conquer the world. So to me, it's important not to settle for anything but the best. Dialog Television is our window to the world. It brings us the widest range of knowledge, information and entertainment from across Sri Lanka and the globe, from education for our kids to the latest movies. Dialog Television, powered by the very latest in digital satellite technology, connects the world to every Sri Lankan home. Dialog is the future today.
Don't be constrained. Be versatile. Be flexible. You have the power. Set talk time, SMS and data quotas to match your style and enjoy the full potential of your mobile package. It's my plan from Dialog. Absolute power to you.
To create your own plan, visit www.dialog.lk/myplan or call 1-777 for more information.
Now Now, reserving your train tickets is as easy as reaching for your Dialog mobile. Just dial 444 and get instantly connected with the Dialog Explorail ticket reservation service. A new and hassle-free way to discover the breathtaking sights and sounds of Sri Lanka is now conveniently at your fingertips, anytime, anywhere. Dial 444 to reserve your Explorail train ticket today. Dialog, the future today.
Serving over 240 million customers across Asia. Asiata, advancing Asia.
This is iPhone 6S. Not much has changed, except it responds to the pressure of your finger. So you can peek into stuff. And pop stuff open, which changes how you play a song. Read a text. Read an email. Read the news. Wait, you read the news?
Yep.
Of course you do. Now you can change apps like this. Pay at more places like this. And the new color looks like this. It's rose gold. It's awesome. And Siri is more helpful than ever.
Hey, Siri, show me photos of tortellini.
Here are some images of tortellini.
Maybe get takeout? The camera shoots 4K video now, which changes how your movies look. Nice. Even selfies have changed. Now your screen is the flash. That's going to get like a million likes.
Thanks.
Actually, photos themselves have changed. They move now. You just touch them. So yeah, that's what's changed.
Now transact with over 40 million EasyCash customers via Dialog, Etisalat and Hutch. Dial #111# to register today. Now use selected commercial bank ATMs to withdraw EasyCash at your convenience.
Now I can withdraw EasyCash from any commercial bank ATM which displays the EasyCash logo. Select cardless transactions. Select your preferred language. Select EasyCash. Type in the amount you need. Enter your EasyCash account number. You will receive a message onto your mobile. Enter your EasyCash PIN and send to complete your transaction.
Now use commercial bank ATMs to withdraw EasyCash at your convenience. Call 7111 for more information. EasyCash, money in your mobile.
Connect to Sri Lanka's largest Wi-Fi network with over 2,500 hotspots across the country. Cafes, restaurants, colleges, hospitals, bus stands, train stations, and many more. Select Dialog Wi-Fi and visit wifi.dialog.lk to register and get your username and password. Choose from four easy ways to top up your account. Go Wi-Fi, go Dialog.
Sri Lanka is a small but proud nation, and we know we can conquer the world. So to me, it's important not to settle for anything but the best. Dialog Television is our window to the world. It brings us the widest range of knowledge, information and entertainment from across Sri Lanka and the globe, from education for our kids to the latest movies. Dialogue Television, powered by the very latest in digital satellite technology, connects the world to every Sri Lankan home. Dialogue is the future today.
Don't be constrained. Be versatile, be flexible. You have the power. Set talk time, SMS and data quotas to match your style and enjoy the full potential of your mobile package. It's my plan from Dialogue. Absolute power to you.
To create your own plan, visit www.dialogue.lk/myplan or call 1-777 for more information.
Now, reserving your train tickets is as easy as reaching for your Dialogue mobile. Just dial 444 and get instantly connected with the Dialogue ExpoRail ticket reservation service. A new and hassle-free way to discover the breathtaking sights and sounds of Sri Lanka is now conveniently at your fingertips, anytime, anywhere. Dial 444 to reserve your ExpoRail train ticket today. Dialogue, the future today.
Serving over 240 million customers across Asia. Asiata, advancing Asia.
This is iPhone 6S. Not much has changed, except it responds to the pressure of your finger. So you can peek into stuff. And pop stuff open, which changes how you play a song. Read a text. Read an email. Read the news. Wait, you read the news?
Yep.
Of course you do. Now you can change apps like this. Pay at more places like this. And the new color looks like this. It's rose gold. It's awesome. And Siri is more helpful than ever.
Hey Siri, show me photos of tortellini.
Here are some images of tortellini.
Maybe get takeout? The camera shoots 4K video now, which changes how your movies look. Nice. Even selfies have changed. Now your screen is the flash. That's gonna get like a million likes.
Thanks.
Actually, photos themselves have changed. They move now. You just touch them. So yeah, that's what's changed.
Now, transact with over 40 million EasyCash customers via Dialogue, Etisalat and Hutch. Dial #111# to register today. Now, use selected commercial bank ATMs to withdraw EasyCash at your convenience.
Now, I can withdraw EasyCash from any commercial bank ATM which displays the EasyCash logo. Select cardless transactions. Select your preferred language. Select EasyCash. Type in the amount you need. Enter your EasyCash account number. You will receive a message onto your mobile. Enter your EasyCash PIN and send to complete your transaction.
Now, use commercial bank ATMs to withdraw EasyCash at your convenience. Call 7111 for more information. EasyCash, money in your mobile.
Connect to Sri Lanka's largest Wi-Fi network with over 2,500 hotspots across the country. Cafes, restaurants, colleges, hospitals, bus stands, train stations, and many more. Select Dialog Wi-Fi and visit wifi.dialog.lk to register and get your username and password. Choose from four easy ways to top up your account. Go Wi-Fi, go Dialog.
Hello and welcome back to the second half of this Kotmale Shocks Under 19 Schools Football Championship. This is the fourth and final quarter final. Holy Cross College Kalutara leading 2-0 against much fancied Kingswood College. Kingswood College, the Division 2 winners from last year, have done well. They were in the group with Hamid Al Hussein, Maristella. Even though they lost to Hamid Al Hussein 2-1, they won against Maristella, one of the other quarter finalists. They won that match 3-1 in Kandy. So much was talked about this Kingswood side, that they would be able to get into the semi-final, and an uphill task in the second half. Down 2-0, they need to score as well as defend quite equally. And I'm joined in commentary for the second half by Fazlan. Fazlan, what do you think Kingswood need to do in the second half?
I think they have to do a couple of changes in positions, so that like bringing Anjana as a striker, so that it will help them score goals. I think what they lack is a person who could score goals, a person who could shoot the ball to the nets. That's what they lack, I guess. And as you can see, Anjan has moved forward. I think my guess is right.
Absolutely right, Fazlan. He has come into midfield position, so he would be able to drop back in defense and come as a striker. Good option, given that their defense has not been good, and he's the only man that who can run up and down. The Sri Lanka under 19 player.
Indeed, Ravod. Indeed, but at the same time, we cannot forget that Anjana alone cannot score goals. He needs support by his teammates, which I did not see in the first half. And I think he will be able to score with the help of his wingers. There goes the right wing for Kingswood College.
Kingswood College need an early goal to settle their nerves. Down 2-0, and the long it goes, and it stays 2-0. The more happy would the Holy Cross players be, eh? And now they have the chance. But the keeper coming out, rushing out, puts in a brilliant tackle to keep the scores 2-0. Wonderful opportunity there. Once again, poor defending there from the Kingswood lads.
That was due to miscommunication, Nawod, and that was a golden opportunity for Holy Cross. They were 2-1, just the goalkeeper in the back. Poor ball controlling over there by the Holy Cross striker. If he had passed the ball earlier to his teammate, he could have easily scored the goal, as the goalkeeper moved forward and the other striker was open all alone.
Going for glory himself. There was that Holy Cross player.
That's Vijay Narayan for Kingswood College, wearing the jersey number 16. And now we have Dilruan taking the free kick for Kingswood College. Dilruan thinking of placing it into the box. And yes, he looks for the far post over there. Goalkeeper of Holy Cross clears it very well.
Menuka Rohit, that was coming way out and punching it away. Now on the left inside the box, tries and put in a ball opportunity. The keep out of his lines,
But by the looks of it, it was Abdul Qadir who was unable to put in a good cross for his striker. Now on the right comes Holy Cross, but the ball is stolen by the lads from Kandy. Referee sees a handball and gives a free kick near the halfway line for Holy Cross.
What cost them the goal, Nawod? What I think is the Kingswood defenders move forward and they do not get back to their position during the counter attack. Is that what you think?
More so, Fazlan, I think that comes into consideration as once again another chance for Holy Cross. Ball trickling away down at the near post. Goal kick nonetheless for Kingswood. I think when you counter attack, you need players who can drop back as well. You cannot push every man forward. And sometimes when a team looks to play on the counter attack like Holy Cross have done, it's very difficult to any side to cope with, as you saw against the match against St. Sebastian's College Katun area and St. Peter's College. St. Peter's College piled on men forward. They created the chances, but the one or two chances that St. Sebastian's College created, they were able to score and win that match against the much fancied, the star-studded St. Peter's College. As the light now quickly fades away here at the racecourse grounds, we hope that today the lights would come on a bit earlier, not like yesterday, isn't it, Fazla?
I hope so, Nawod. I think the organizers have learned their lesson just after what happened yesterday. Even the screen went too dark and none of our spectators could watch clear football.
Absolutely. Holy Cross player, that was number 7, one of the goal scorers here, that's Nilesh Kavinda. Playmaker for Holy Cross, he has done well throughout this season in this tournament for the lads from Kalutara. Once again a poor pass intercepted, the defense is there. It was Shamil Hilmi, Crystal Palace lad. The ball towards Anjana goes out and he's not pleased with that pass.
Anjana taking the game all by himself as he has no support by his teammates. That's quite disappointing, as football is not like any other sport. It is a team game, and that's a wonderful through pass by the Holy Cross winger, number 14, Pagit Malche Fernando. Holy Cross making the best out of the opportunities they get, and that's a highlight for them. If Kingswood also could make the best out of the opportunities they get, I'm pretty sure they'll score many goals as possible.
Now once again Nilesh bringing the ball forward and the defense clears it. Lot of defenders around and near the penalty box. And Kingswood need to be careful because they shouldn't only rely upon Anjana, because I think the Holy Cross lads would also know that he's a Sri Lanka player, Sri Lanka under 19 player, and would mark him well. So that option quickly fades away for Kingswood. They need to find some other option, especially Qadir and Shamil, who is playing in midfield.
and that's a foul caused by number 7, Dilruan of Kingswood College. I'm pretty impressed how this match went so far by not giving any offsides. Like yesterday, they had many offsides in both the quarterfinals, and it is pretty disappointing as it is the under 19 football standard is not up to the level of we expect. What do you think, Nawood?
Well, Fazlan, the offsides, I think it's a tactical plan which comes into play from the players and the coaching staff, because I know what you mean, because you need to be careful when you're going forward, the defense line is there. But sometimes the defenders, the opposition, are a bit smarter than you and catch you offside when you're playing a very high defense line. So that comes into play. But like you said, the awareness matters. The under 19 boys needs to be careful, because you need to know what's happening around you as well. Not about the ball coming to you, about the players, but the opposition as well.
I see Vijay Narayana and Anjana Vikram Singh have switched positions. Both of them have switched from left to right as strikers. I hope this will make a change in the score sheet, as Holy Cross is leading the game 2-0.
Bit of Ajibaji there from both the sides. Kingswood College not happy at all. They need to be careful. The discipline is not that good from what we've seen in the group stages. As a shot is taken, and the player loves the ball to go towards the goal, calmly collected by the goalkeeper, because in that match against Ananda College back in Kandy, even though they won that match 3-0, that was the score, they had two red cards towards the end of the match. So in a match they were winning, to get two red cards is quite unbelievable.
Of course, now it is as school players, they need to be very well disciplined, and the key to success is discipline, not anything else. Of course, you need practice and skills, knowledge, but more than any of them, you need discipline.
Good ball here down towards the byline, but a bit too much power on it as it evades that left winger. Man is down for Kingswood College.
I think that's M. Shamil, the right defender. No, that is not M. Shamil.
Cramps are a common sight here, the race course grounds, especially with these kids. This is a very, very soft ground built mainly for rugby. So, and players who haven't played here find it very hard, even the lads from St. Henry's College who should be having a good fitness levels find it very hard here, because the calves get stretched quite a lot in this soft ground.
I'm sorry, that was M. Nazir of Kingswood College who went down due to a cramp.
Kingswood now playing with 10 as number 2.
There goes Holy Cross again with a good strike. Number 2 for Holy Cross.
That was Asela Madushan, who went on a solo run going past 2-3 defenders.
I don't know why, Nawood, but he had options on his left. He could have passed the ball, but yet he chose to take a shot.
Absolutely, at this level, sometimes you are a bit selfish, but you need to take those options when you have it. That's how you learn football, as the throw-in comes in.
Of course, now the striker has to be selfish to score goals. That's a bit of clumsy football over there by the Kingswood defend.
But not too selfish, isn't it, Fazlur?
Yes, not too selfish. True enough, Nawood. I think the centre backs of Kingswood College are not stable enough. As after Anjana moved out, I see both the centre backs are passing the ball to each other, which is not a good sign. As football players, you should know not to pass to your centre back mate, as it could be easily intercepted by the striker.
Absolutely, unless you are very confident with your centre back partner, because from what I see, the centre back partner is Shamil Hilmi, one of them, because he plays in midfield in the first half, and now since Anjana has moved up front, he has gone into centre back position, and I'm absolutely sure that these two doesn't have much communication, and especially Shamil is not a regular centre back, he's a midfielder, so you cannot take risks with that. As Holy Cross players taking a bit of time with the free kick, there's going to be a substitution. That's number 22 KB, number 22, that's Nirmal Asela, who is coming on, and the number 14, that's going off for Holy Cross, Malsha Fernando. Number 14 going off, Nirmal Asela, number 22 coming on. Almost an hour gone in this match. Holy Cross leading 2-0 as the free kick comes in towards the edge of the box. Holy Cross still has it, but intercepted. Not a good pass there. Once again, sloppy passing by both the sides. And this time allows Holy Cross player number 7, Kavind Kumara, tries a through ball. Good defending there once again by Kingswood.
Holy Cross has gone down to 10 men now. Number 12, Ashen Primanta, is out due to an injury. As you can see, there are only 10 players on the field. Over here, Kingswood College playing as if they are leading the game. Not a good sign for Kingswood. If they do not move the ball forward, they will not be able to score a single goal.
That's not a pass you need from a club level player. Shamil Hilmi putting the pass straight to the Holy Cross player, and now they come on the attack. Another ball slipped away, opportunity here, but fortunately for Kingswood, their goalkeeper number 25, GM Alice, was able to collect it on his second attempt. The Holy Cross player was there to pounce on that mistake. If that had gone in, it would have been curtains for the lads from Kandy. Now Anjana, looking for support, no one there. Poor pass, somehow manages to get to that Kingswood player. Now inside the box, options to his right, but takes a bit too much time. Good sliding tackle, earns a corner. He was taking a bit too much time. That was the Kingswood player, number 9, PD Pathirana.
Like I said, now Kingswood is playing like as if they are leading the game, and that is not a good sign for them. It was also the winger's mistake, Dilruan, who controlled the ball outside his position, and he could not cross it over to the center of the box. As these players are not kids anymore, they should try to think much faster than they are, so that their reaction will be very quicker. That could have been an easy goal for Kingswood. They were just three players against three and they did not score. There goes another player for Holy Cross College, and that's jersey number six.
Kingswood College has the ball, not showing any urgency here. Casual play, 1-2 passing, tackled hard. Too casual from the Kingswood lads. Once again, poor control. And a foul.
You cannot call it a foul as it was a 50-50 ball now. But at the end of the day, it is referee's call which matters and we have no choice on that. That kick taken by Govinda Sudeep for Holy Cross straight away goes out of the pitch. Yet again, Kingswood ball. Kingswood takes the out kick. Very well headed by the number 16, Roshan Subhash. There's the number 7, the playmaker, Nilesh Kavinda Kumara for Holy Cross. There's fancy football over there by Anjana Vikramasinghe. Not very successful. Lack of communication by the Kingswood players over there. There's Nilesh Kavinda Kumara again, trying to send through passes in between the defenders. Not good enough. Kingswood throw in again. Number 17 for Kingswood. We have Jayasantha. There goes Jayasantha. There goes Anjan on the left wing. Sri Lankan strike over there for Kingswood College. A very good cross, but not good enough to reach the teammate. Anjan again. And referee says it's throw in favor of Holy Cross. Like I mentioned earlier, Nawod, Anjana does not have enough support by his teammates at least to get the ball into the box. It's pretty disappointing for a player like Anjana as he is a Sri Lankan star and his teammates should know to support him so that he could reach his goal as well.
Absolutely, Anjana must be very frustrated as once again number 7 going on a solo run and trying to put in a very long through ball when he had options to his left and right. Number 7 for Kingswood College is Dilruan. Once again, he's not taking the short option. Players coming in support on his left and the right, but look, always going for the long ball. Long through ball, which always is intercepted by the Holy Cross lads. So once again, the decisions taken has costed the Kingswood College in good positions.
if Nilesh Kavinda Kumara continues to play like this, my guess is he'll be the man of the match, as he is the playmaker for Holy Cross. And also, not to forget, we have number 12 in the defense line, Ashen Premanta, who has been playing a major role in the defense line as a left back. There goes a little bit of half and pass over there by Ashen Premanta, the left back. And the referee gives a yellow card to Ashen. Pretty disappointing to receive a yellow card in school level, isn't it, Nawab?
Still the Ajibaji going on down near the touchline. I thought the referee was a bit too lenient. I think even after that tackle, yes indeed it was a horrible tackle, it should earn him a yellow card. But the reaction from that Kingswood player is unwanted. And the goalkeeper also came off his lines down to the touchline to have a word with that Kingswood lad. So these things should not happen, and the discipline should be held up in these matches, especially when the referee is in control.
I guess maturity level will teach them how to react in these kind of situations. That's Anjana Vikram Singh taking the free kick for Kingswood College Candy. Anjana with his left foot over there. As he has many options, he chooses the ball to kick to the goal post. Not very successful over there. Kingswood ball is getting back on to the position. That's Ashen again grabbing the ball from Kingswood. Yet again Holy Cross trying to bounce back, and that's a good one. We have the left winger for Holy Cross. A good pass into the center by to Nilesh, and Nilesh takes a shot. Wonderful goal by Nilesh. A wonderful shot taken by Nilesh Kavinda Kumara, the playmaker for Holy Cross. Right on top of the box. Goalkeeper had no choice. He tried his level best. And that's the Holy Cross boys celebrating the goal. The third goal, of course. So that's the second goal for Nilesh Kavinda Kumara, and the third goal for Holy Cross College Kaltura. Kingswood College down 3-0.
I think the match is all but over for the Kingswood lads. 3-0 is the score by Holy Cross. And once again, an opportunity here. Good through ball. Will it be the fourth? And yes, it is. Brilliant stuff. Brilliant through ball. And it was a number. 2, Asela Madushan, who scored that goal, wonderful through ball, running around the goalkeeper and slotting it into the open goal. Wonderful stuff from the lads from Kalutara.
I thought Kingswood will have a comeback in the second half. Unfortunately, it's Holy Cross Kalutara who is dominating the game. It's 4-0 in favor of Holy Cross, and that was the fourth goal by Asela Madushan, the striker, along with Nilesh Kavindakumar. That was a wonderful team play over there by the Kalutara boys. Kingswood do not have enough time to get back to the game, and that's a yellow card awarded to the number 7 of Kingswood. We have Dilruan awarded a yellow card for his tackles. Referee says play on, and the kick is taken by Govinda Sudeep, the defender of Holy Cross. As you can see, he does not have many options in front. He has only 3 players, and that's 2 goal scorers. And there's a substitution for Holy Cross. There goes the number 11, Nirmal Udara Pereira. I would say Holy Cross made the best out of the opportunities they got, and Kingswood did not make it useful enough.
Kingswood College, coming into this match, from what I have seen, did not have a proper plan. Starting with Anjana Vikramasinghe at centre back in defence, your prominent striker, your main striker, always not a good sign. Sri Lanka player as well, so he has loads of experience, and to use him as a centre back is quite puzzling. And I think the game was revolved around him and Shamil Hilmi. Those two were the guys who were supposed to make the breaks for the lads from Kandy, but it didn't come from them, as the Holy Cross lads really marked them quite wonderfully. And it was always the teamwork of the Holy Cross lads that has led them to this win, not just one or two players. Yes, indeed, that's Nilesh Kavindakumar. He scored 2 goals, and Asela Madushan scored 1 as well. Opportunity here for number 23. Opportunity gone begging once again. That was Abdul Kadir. His effort blocked off the line by the goalkeeper. Brilliant stuff. That's Menuka Rohit denying Kingswood that goal. But even if that had gone in, still it would be a long way off for the Kingswood lads to make a comeback.
Even if that had gone in, they would have had to score 3 more goals to equalize the game, which is not going to happen with the defense line having 5 defenders.
Absolutely, and that goalkeeper was ball watching, not listening to his defender's call. That was Anjana Vikramasinghe, who was coming way off his line. Very slow from that goalkeeper. Kingswood College goalkeeper Vijay Ratna, who had a good game against St. Joseph's College, where Kingswood needed to win in order to book a place in the quarterfinal. But today he's been found wanting, conceding 4 goals, albeit because of some poor defending as well in front of him.
As you can see, Anjana Vikramasinghe has come back to the position where he was as the defender. not a very good sign over there. 3-3.
Asela. Kavinda back to Asela. Good play by both of them. I think both of them have a good understanding. Just one touch football. Releasing that man, that's what you need from these guys.
As you can see now, right now they have 5 defenders. Holy Cross has 5 defenders and only another 4 or 5 of them playing up front. And with those 5 of them, they still manage to gain a couple of goals, and that's the wonder of their team. That's Nilesh again. Wonderful cross over there. Nilesh again with the ball. Not a very good pass over there. Anjana with the counter attack. A cross over there to his fellow teammate. Very good cross. Very well controlled. And yet again another pass over there. Poor kick by the striker.
Number 6, Vijay Nara. And that was an open goal for him. And he skies it over. That's what pressure can do.
This is the second chance they had, and they had a chance just like this earlier and they missed it. Yet again they missed this as well. These chances cost the game for Kingswood. As you can see, number 23 walks out for Kingswood College.
It was Abdul Qadir who goes off. Missed one opportunity just a few minutes back for... And the new man coming in is number 5 for Kingswood, LHM Bandara. Well, quite some interesting thing, Fazlan, if you look at the team card, the new guy, number 5, LHM Bandara, if you just take off the spellings, the dots, it's Lam Bandara.
Yes, of course, now it's the... Captain of the World Cup winning team, Germany. Pretty interesting facts over here by Nawad Vijay Vikrama.
And of course, to all of you joining on www.thepapare.com, just a reminder that all the photos published and the videos on thepapare.com are available for purchase. Just send us your info to editor@thepapare.com or call us on 077-333-0088. Our hotline 077-333-0088.
And do not forget to get our live updates on all the social media hubs. Please follow us as we bring live actions around the country to you. That's M. Nazir with the throw-in for Kingswood College.
Just over 10 minutes to go in this match. As the Holy Cross players make a few changes. That's number 8 who is going off. Muhammad Sahami. And number 4 coming on. For the last from Kalutara, Dimuthu Krishanta. Narayana to Anjana. Anjana going down the wing. Still going. All on his own. Looking for options. Cuts back and puts in a cross. A good cross. 3 men there. But once again, poor first touch. Allowing Kumara to clear. Nilesh carving the Kumara. Who almost certainly will be our man of the match, isn't it, Fazlan?
Yes, Nawo. That's my choice. And his game is totally different compared to other players in his team and in his opposition. Extraordinary game over there by Nilesh Kavind, and his shot on top of the box, which was the third goal for Holy Cross, and the second goal for him was brilliant stuff. That's him again with the cross.
I think Nilesh have controlled this midfield quite exceptionally for Holy Cross. He has dominated the midfield. That's how they've taken the upper hand, Holy Cross, against Kingswood College, creating the chances almost everywhere. Every time the ball is with Holy Cross, and even in defense, like you see right now, Nilesh coming back in defense, tries to put in a good ball, but this time finds a defender. And what Kingswood have lacked today is their midfielders. I think inconsistency is what I would call. Sometimes they would have Shamil Hilmi, they would shift him back to defense, so they haven't allowed any player to settle down into not that midfield position, which is quite important, especially in the central midfield position where you create stuff. And the good example is Nilesh Kumar.
Not only that, now the what I see is the lack of teamwork and not enough communication between the teammates. As you saw, the defenders who were passing to each other had no they didn't have a mutual understanding, and that cost a lot of good chances for the Holy Cross team. So mistakes like that happens, but once in a while. But in this game, there were many mistakes like that. So what I think is that it should not happen. Holy Cross playing with 5 to 6 defenders, pretty impressive. Only 4 in up front. And those 4 players are doing very well. Anjana back in his position over there as a centre back.
And that's what's more impressive, isn't it, Fazlan? I think even with 4 players up front, they've every now and then manages to create the chances with Bandara at the centre of it.
That, of course, now you have to appreciate their fitness levels. They could go up and down. And what I think is a player could get disturbed mentally by switching his position a couple of times in one match, and it can affect the other teammates as well. Isn't it, Nawood?
Absolutely, because you come into a match to play in a certain role where you prepare yourself to play in a midfield position. And yes, a coach would tell him that sometimes you would need to change and all, but that should come before the match, not halfway through the match, like for Anjana and Shamil, because Shamil is not a defender, but he was asked to be in that defensive position at halftime. Now he's in a midfield position right now, passing it out wide to number 14. And Kingswood College earns another free kick on the edge of the box.
That's Anjana Vikram Singh walking towards the ball, coming all the way from the defense line just to take the free kick. Just few minutes away from the final whistle, and this could be the only opportunity they could get in the last few minutes.
Got a couple of free kicks. He missed them, and shooting straight at the defense as well this time around.
That's Anjana again on the left wing. Referee calls it a foul, and the free kick is awarded to Holy Cross College, Kaltura. You could see only three players out front for Holy Cross. And that's going to Sudeep. Nilesh again, and the referee says offside. This was the second offside in this game, which is very impressive, as the yesterday's matches had many offsides. What I've seen so far is as soon as any Kingswood player gets the ball, they look into Anjana, as they think they have no choice. That's Kingswood again. Kingswood trying their level best to get a goal in the last few minutes. To the fans who just turned into the page, Holy Cross over here has scored 4-0. And joining with me over here, Ranjico Pereira. What do you have to say, Ranjico?
Yes, dominant performance again from Holy Cross Kalutara. The second team from Kandy who was dominated today in the matches, as it's a good run by the Kingswood player, but again, the strong defense line of Holy Cross up to the task. Final few minutes as the light is slowly dimming away at the racecourse grounds. Don't think the lights are needed today. The match will be over soon. We are into the final 5 minutes of the match.
So Holy Cross will be facing St. Henry's College Jaffna. Both the teams have scored 4 in their quarterfinal. I guess their semi-final match would be very interesting, with a tough fight to gain a spot in the finals.
So I guess so, and that number 2 was deemed offside there. Holy Cross are looking for more goals towards the end of this match. They've already grabbed hold of this encounter, this quarterfinal. They've already sealed their position in the semi-final, as another good cross-in by number 2.
As I've informed that there's only 2 minutes left for the final whistle. Not having much time for Kingswood College. There goes the final whistle, and the match is in favor of Holy Cross College Kaltura with 4-0.
Yes, a brilliant display of football by the boys from Kaltura. Win the match 4-0, and they seal the final spot in the semi-final. So, thank you for joining us here today. This live coverage of the quarterfinal.
And for the semifinals, we have Holy Cross College versus St. Henry's. And on the other side, we have Zaira College versus Zaire College versus St. Sebastian's Cartagena. St. Sebastian's College from Cartagena. Stay tuned with us with ThePapare.com for live actions. And stay tuned for the semifinals, which will be on the 16th of February, which is next week. Thank you for listening. Signing off, I'm Fazlan Faizia.
I'm Raji Cabrera, sharing the passion.
Yes, sir. On the